It's a very important question that your forum has raised today about the importance of buying a ready-to-move-in property. I have been in the business since the last 35 years and have delivered more than 3,500 apartments and on way to develop another 3,000 apartments in Mumbai, in MMR and out of the country too. Whenever any friend of mine were to approach me or my dearest friend or my sister or my brother, I always advise them only one thing: buy a ready-to-move-in property with occupation certificate. And I'll give you a few reasons, a few simple reasons why I feel that in my limited experience, this is the best thing to do. Number one, everybody who buys a home looks forward to a dream, looks forward to an aspiration, and looks forward to make his family and himself a very happy person. So when you buy a ready-to-move-in property, first of all, you are able to see what is the light, what is the ventilation, what is the view, who is going to be my neighbor, who are the people who are staying in the building. Then, if the builder has said that the carpet area is 700 square feet, you can actually measure, is it 700? Is it 690? Is it 710? You can go and ring a bell among the neighbors in the building and ask them, is the water coming on time? Is the electricity coming on time? Are the parking systems okay? Is the lift working properly? So on and so forth. And whether that flat at any time in the past, has anybody lived in it? So I would say that buying a home is also equal to taking a very important decision in your life, like whom to get married to, whom will your daughter get married to, whom will your son get married to, and how do you see everything in real time. You don't see a fictitious groom or a fictitious bride or a groom or a bride in the making. You know, I mean, there is nothing like that, because it's a decision for your lifetime. So in my view, it is extremely important for a person that he gets this chance to check with everything. And more than that, if he wants to upgrade his life, see, in Mumbai today, 60 to 70% of the mid-luxury market, that is above 1 crore, 1.5 crore, 2, 3 crores, are such sales today where people want to sell their existing apartment and upgrade to a better apartment, or a joint family selling their existing space and then buying 2, 3, 4 apartments depending upon the size of the family that is to be accommodated. One other great advantage of ready-to-move-in is you are able to check the titles of the property. You are able to know what is the maintenance cost. The best thing is that you start enjoying your life the day you occupy your flat. What I have seen in some of my friends who are financial experts, they say, okay, I will go for an under construction property because the prices are about 10-15% less and I get a payment facility. So after 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, they get their home. By the time my friend Suresh Mehta, who was an assistant manager, he has already become an AGM or a DGM or a GM. So, but when he booked the flat, he thought, what was his level? He was at this level. By the time he got the flat, his rank has come to 2 or 3 notches or 1 notch above. So again, when he goes to take the possession of the flat, his wife says, our colleagues in the office have a better apartment than us. But when you buy a ready-to-move-in property, depending upon what your status today is, you buy according to that, according to the bank loan eligibility. And then after 3, 4, 5, 7 years, you can then shift to a better apartment. So there is a proper linkage and you start enjoying your quality of life from the day you move into the ready-to-move-in apartment. People don't realize that they have a limited life, and in that limited life, you work so hard to make your wife, your children, your parents and others happy. When you buy an under construction thing, you may get the possession after 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. But till such time, wherever you are living, what about that? Whereas if you move in today, you start enjoying all the facilities, amenities in the building from day one itself. So these are the reasons why I strongly recommend that people who actually want to live, people who want to stay in the home, they must look only for a ready to move in property with occupation certificate. I would like to emphasize on two words which explains what I'm trying to say is missed opportunity and hassle-free buying. Just recently, about 8 to 12 weeks back, I was at my project Mayfair Legends at Malad Evershine Nagar, and a young couple came. The gentleman is a chartered accountant working with one of the four large audit firms, and he had already visited the neighboring projects, that is our competitor projects, and he asked one simple question to Amish, our sales head for Mayfair Legends, that do you have a show flat or a sample flat which you have not yet sold? So Amish said yes. He said, I want to see that. He went up, that he and his wife, after 10 minutes they come down and they say that we want to buy that show flat, we want to buy that sample flat that you have, that is there. So while after the negotiations were over and he gave the check, while he was leaving, I introduced myself to him and I asked him that what made you to ask, is there a show flat which is available? He says, I wanted a complete hassle-free transaction, real estate transaction. And I have seen my so many friends having so much of stress, so much of hassles that they have passed through after they have taken the flat. You know, the kitchen furniture doesn't fit and the bedroom furniture doesn't fit, and then there is a fight between the husband and the wife as to what should be the color and so on and so forth, you know. So I decided that I will buy a ready to move in with OC in a show flat, so that I don't have to look even for the white goods, furniture, nothing. So that is the reason why I have come to take this decision. From this, the learning is very simple, that he wants an hassle-free transaction. And then he said that in my view, the real estate prices for ready-to-move-in projects are likely to go up because there is a short supply, extremely short supply of real estate ready-to-move-in projects. I would like you to do a small exercise. Just decide whichever location in which you want to buy your home. Let's take Borivali, Kandivali, Malad, Thana, wherever. And you ask yourself that how many ready projects are there with OC which are available for me to buy, and you will find that very very few projects in Vikhroli, in Kandivali or in Malad or in Titwala or in other places are available today. So in my view, the prices of ready to move in flats are likely to go up at least by 10 to 20% in the next two quarters because they are in short supply. Well, I think that buying a ready-to-move-in property also means a great financial sense, and I'll tell you why. Five reasons. Number one, the income tax benefit that is available, you start getting the income tax benefits from day one. Depending upon the bank loan that you have taken and your income and other things, the yearly advantage could be anywhere from 2 lakhs to 5 lakhs of rupees, which is not possible or which could get delayed in an under construction property. Second, there is no GST. GST today varies from 8% to 12% and in some cases 18%. In a ready-to-move-in property, you don't have to pay GST. Point number three, you get a higher bank. What happens that when you buy an under-construction property, the builder may have valued the flat at 1 crore. But the financial institution that is financing you may value the flat at 90 lakhs. And hence, the loan to value ratio, even if it is 70%, it may be only 63 lakhs loan eligibility for a flat that you are buying of 1 crore. But when you are buying a ready to move in property, the bank will value the flat based on the transaction that is actually happening, because it is ready, there are no risk in it. So the valuation is higher, so the loan that you can get also is higher. So you can, depending upon your earning capacity, may get even up to 80 to 90% of the cost of the home. So it is higher bank loan. 4. Capital gains benefit. Normally what happens is that when a person sells an existing property, within a certain time he has to invest that money. Now when you invest in an under construction property, you run a risk that in case if there is a delay in the possession of that under construction apartment, you may lose the benefit of the capital gain tax. Here you are immediately able to set off the capital gain tax. And point number 5, you are able to do your financial planning, because you know now what's your EMI, you know what's your maintenance, you know what's the cost of the travel, logistics, etc., etc. So you can plan your finances properly. And yes, one more thing, you can actually see the parking space that you are getting in the building in a ready to move in property. In an under construction property, you don't know where you will end up with your parking space. And one of the biggest botheration in a ready to move in property is that where will I park my car? So, you may end up with a daily botheration of a bad parking space because you have a bigger car and you have a smaller parking space. So these are the financial reasons I feel that a person needs to buy a ready to move in property. And the last point that I want to say about the financial reason is that in the last 6 years, quarter to quarter, announcement of new projects have dropped by 20% to 30% quarter by quarter compounded. So today, out of, let's say for example in Malad, you have about 2000 apartments available today for sale. Not even 40 apartments are ready to move in. And because of that, the inventory of ready to move in is dropping dramatically, and there is chances that the cost of a ready to move in apartment may go higher. Further, the increase in the approving cost, the cost of TDR, the cost of premiums, the development cess, the development charges, the land under construction, the pest control charges, the slum TDR, so on and so forth. This has dramatically increased the cost of approvals. The increase in the cost of petrol, diesel also will lead to increase in the cost of construction. So what is going to happen is that the under construction apartments, the price is going to increase. So rather than facing that uncertainty and waiting to buy tomorrow in an under construction apartment, it is better that you close the deal, buy a ready to move in a property and be done with it, and not have the stress or the tension that tomorrow, what if the prices or the cost of buying a home increases. My take is that ready to move in will become a very important part of the real estate industry, because housing loans have become very easy. To buy a home has also become very easy. So people would actually prefer to actually look at their homes and then decide whether they should buy or not buy. So I feel that ready to move in, almost 50% of the sales that is going to happen in the future are going to be ready to move in properties, which earlier was 90% was under construction, 10% was ready to move in. Now in the future I see that 50% will be, even in affordable housing segments, will be ready to move in, and 50% will be the under construction. And for high value apartments, for high value apartments about 3 crores. More than 80% will be for ready to move in. And one of the key differentiators is the GST. Because on a ready to move in property, you don't have to pay GST. So imagine if you were to buy a flat in Bandra of 10 crores of rupees, you end up paying 1 crore 20 lakhs as GST. Whereas if you were to buy it as a ready to move in with occupation certificate, there is no GST to be paid. So I feel that ready to move in will become a very important part of the real estate industry. I think, in a ready to move in property, the most important thing that I would advise my customers to keep in mind is to have a thorough inspection of each and everything that is connected to that apartment, to their neighbors, to the facilities, to the amenities, to the approvals, to the title, to the approach, to the maintenance cost, to the best home loan deal available on that day, whether it's State Bank or HDFC or ICICI or any other PSU bank for that matter. So, normally now everybody knows about it, that does the property have an occupation certificate, does the property have water connection, does the property have electric connection. These are very basic things that you obviously check on it. But more than that, I would suggest that the customers do a thorough inspection of the entire layout. I call that walk the talk. They should do a walk the talk with the sales head of that project and check for themselves each and everything that they look forward to enjoy in that day. Yes, we won the award for Mayfair Vishwaraja, and it was awarded the best affordable housing project completed. And we are very proud of it. We are very happy that the industry recognized this as the most affordable housing project. I would like to say that in most of the projects, almost 30 or 40% or 50% only of the stocks get sold before the occupation certificate. Whereas Mayfair Vishwaraja has been one project where more than 80% of the or 85% of our apartments got sold before the occupation certificate. So what is very satisfying for Mayfair is that more than 200 customers kept faith on Mayfair. That they, before seeing the actual project, they bought the dream that we gave to them. They bought the aspiration that we gave to them. And we are so happy that we were able to satisfy all these customers. So the happiness comes from promise delivered. And that happiness comes when we look into the face of the customers who say, okay, yes, the project is lovable, the project is likable, the project is enjoyable, and it is beautiful in our mind. And the project's location is excellent. It is next to the one of the 8 Siddhi Vinayaks of India, and it faces the Kalu River. Very well, extremely well connected. And thanks to HDFC who financed this project. And incidentally, this was the first project in the country that was registered under MAHARERA, and each and every compliances that MAHARERA required us to do, we did it before. On 1st May 2018, which marked the 12 months, the first anniversary of MAHARERA in the country, all the stakeholders, the consumer body, CREDAI MCHI, NAREDCO, the MAHARERA conciliatory forum, all of them came together, and plus others, and MAHARERA itself came together to organize a workshop from morning 9 to evening 6 o'clock on how Mahera progressed over the 12 months. And one of the most outstanding things that the Honorable Chief Minister noted, and Shri Gautam Chatterjee, the Chief of Mahera, noted was that on the night of 30th April, that is when 1st May started, there was a developer and who was awake, 12 people in his office were working to, and they started applying to Mahera to fill up the entire form for registration of the project. And they said that it is, you know, the enthusiasm that you showed, the belief that you kept on Mahera, that Mahera is something good for a developer. So, you know, it was not only because of we were the first person, it was also that the volition that we carried, Mayfair carried as a developer, it wanted to demonstrate the entire real estate industry that Mahera is a friend. We don't have to be afraid of Mahera. And to comply with Mahera and get your project registered is in fact a feather in your cap, and you don't have to worry about it as one more permission and one more government body that is going to come your way. So it was because of that probably that the Honorable Chief Minister and the Chief of Mahera decided to recognize this contribution that Mayfair Housing made by registering Mahera as the first project in the country. We look forward to that for each and every project that we are going to do is to register them under Mahera and, you know, in letter and spirit ensure that we comply to the customer satisfaction and we comply to whatever are the conditions laid down by Mahera authorities.